In the first 6 months of my career, I have raised more than 2,000 defects. After what? Yes, same. So today, we are going to discuss top 5 mistakes made by tester, or I am going to share my experience. If you are new to Fundo Tester, please consider subscribing it. After this small intro, we are going to start. Without any ado, let's get started. So early in my career, in first 6 months, I have raised more than 2000 defects. After what? I was overconfident. It was not a negative side, but still, after that, I have learned so many things. In the first year of my career, I learned Selenium, Cucumber, Java, whatnot, all the tools. I know each and everything, but I know only basic things. I cannot work without any guidance or anything. So what I am saying is, if you are adding so many tools and so many libraries in your resume, it doesn't make sense. If you have 3 years experience, it's okay to learn one language and one tool, but the end goal is you should be able to work, you should be able to complete your task, or you should take ownership of any task. So that is the end goal of the company or any organization. My second mistake was learning without goals. What does it mean? As I told, in early in my career, I started learning everything. Selenium, Python, Java, APM, API, everything. But I don't know where I am going. So you need to decide your learning goals. For example, you are working for an X company. Then you have to decide after 2 years, or after 3 years, or after 5 years, where you want to reach. For example, after currently you are working for a company, and then you want to switch for the certain set of the company, for example X, Y and Z. So you need to start learning based on your next goal. For example, your next three companies, they are working on a Selenium or particular tools or particular skills, so you need to develop that skill. Another example I can say that early in 2018, if I'm not wrong, there was a booming of Protector and Python plus Selenium. People are learning like anything. Everyone was discussing on the Protector and Python plus Selenium on social media. But still nowadays in 2021, most of the company do work on Selenium plus Java, or Protector is nowhere, or few people or few organizations are working on Protector. So don't just run behind the tools, but you can learn few tools. For example, Selector Hub, which is developed by the Sanjay Kumar. So if you are going to learn the Selector Hub, it will take maximum 1 or 2 days, but using that you can save your time. For example, you are working on a UI automation and you are using the Selector Hub, you can easily decrease your time to just writing a good expert. Selector Hub will give you a good expert. So if the tools is helping you, then undoubtedly you should learn. Third is, never waste your time on manual basis automation or any other discussions on the social media, LinkedIn or Twitter or whatever. Be focused. Many people are saying functional testing is good, functional testing is good. Some are saying automation, automation, automation. But what is it? If someone is saying functional testing is good and they are at a senior position, at the industry lead, are they going to hire manual testers or functional testers? They are saying functional testing is good, then are they going to hire? This is my question. If someone is saying automation is good, then what about the functional testing? Will functional testing not find jobs in future? No one can say like that. So focus on your goals. Never distract. Fourth one is, don't stuck in problems. Yes, why I am saying this? Because if you are doing certain task for in your company or day-to-day work, you stuck at problem E. So go to your managers, go to your peers. If you are not able to find the solution, go to social media, go to Stack Overflow, ask in the testing forums. You will get the answer soon. But don't waste your time as well as the organization time. Next is, don't learn many things at one time, or you should learn one thing at one time. For example, just make a goal. For example, today in current year I am going to learn API. So be focused. Do your work and be focused on your learning. You have to learn in and out everything of IDBI. So next year you can plan for the Selenium. Next to next year you can plan for the APM. If you have plans like this for upcoming 3 to 4 years, you can easily learn many things. So in 1 year you can be good at programming language. Next year you can be good at the UI automation. Next to next year you can be good at mobile automation. So within 3 to 4 years you will see the drastic changes. So that's why I'm telling you, learn single thing at a time. I hope this will help you. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer. Thank you so much. And before leaving, please subscribe Fundo Testers.